thank you for being with us today. At this time, we ask that you please turn off your cell phones. And we also ask that you refrain from chewing gum during the Mass. Please stand to begin our celebration. Thank you.
The greatness of the Lord. Let us sing joyously. The greatness of the Lord. Sing to God a new song. May the earth sing to the Lord. We sing to the Lord. We sing to the Lord. The King of all creation. Let us sing joyously the greatness of the Lord. Let us sing joyously the greatness of the Lord. Lord, recognize His glory, His power. Tribute Him with honor, tribute Him with honor. The King of all creation. Let us sing joyously the greatness of the Lord. Sing joyously the greatness of the Lord.
We worship the Lord of the temple. Let our voice rumble in His presence. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, the King of all creation.
Sing joyously the greatness of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to the Basilica of Our Lady of San Juan del Valle. Let us present our intentions, our petitions. Let us place them in the hands of our Blessed Mother that she may intercede for us. Present those intentions, those petitions to our Heavenly Father. In order to be better prepared to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins.
I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
are seated at the right hand of the Father, God mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that may be fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Let us listen to the word of God.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the terebinth of Mamre, as he sat in the entrance of his tent while the day was growing hot. Looking up, Abraham saw three men standing nearby. When he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to greet them. And bowing to the ground, he said, "Sir, if I may ask you this favor, please do not go on past your servant. Let some water be brought that you may bathe your feet, and then rest yourselves under the tree. Now that you have come this close to your servant, let me bring you a little food, that you may refresh yourselves, and afterward you may go on your way." The men replied, "Very well, do as you have said." Abraham hastened into the tent and told Sarah, "Quick, 3 measures of fine flour, knead it and make rolls." He ran to the herd, picked out a tender, choice steer, and gave it to a servant who quickly prepared it. Then Abraham got some curds and milk, as well as a steer that had been prepared, and set these before the three men. And he waited on them under the tree while they ate. They asked Abraham, "Where is your wife Sarah?" He replied, "There in the tent." One of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah will then have a son." The word of the Lord.
Oh,
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in afflictions of Christ on behalf of his body, which is the church, of which I am a minister in accordance with God's stewardship given to me to bring the completion for you the word of God, the mystery hidden from ages and from generations past, but now it has been manifested to his holy ones, to whom God chose to make known in the riches of the glory of the mystery among the Gentiles. It is Christ in you, the hope of glory. It is he whom we proclaim, abolishing everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
And some people say, Father, I don't even know how to pray. Don't be worried about that. Just look at him. If you are in front of the Blessed Sacrament, just look at him. If you are in front of the crucifix, just look at him. You don't need to say anything. If you want to express all your needs, and
Pilate, he suffered dead and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We come as travelers in a desert, placing our cares and concerns before God.
For the Holy Father, the bishops, presbyters, deacons, and all the baptized who proclaim the good news, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For political leaders and government workers who guard the dignity of human life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For families in economic crisis, for the financial and spiritual support they need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For working people, for sufficient time for recreation and renewal, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For young people to hear God's call to priesthood and religious life, and for those seeking marriage, that God may lead them in their decisions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, may God give them eternal rest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the health of Guadalupe Tristan, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We'll take a moment in silence for our own intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of justice and mercy, you know our needs and relieve our anxiety. Give us humble hearts and make us worthy of your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Let us continue our celebration.
Father, let Pray, brethren, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and glory of his church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion buried offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew of all, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to a fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Daniel our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face.
Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us now pray with confidence to the Father, in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Receive the Father's blessings.
My brothers, my sisters, this is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to this supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
praises of his love. We receive joyfully the body and blood of the Lord. Blood that transforms our lives, nourishment that is a source of joy. It encourages us to be determined witnesses, to carry the message of the Lord.
Remember to help with the Basilica expenses. Thank you so much for your generosity.
Holy, holy, holy.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I want to remind you we have the blessing for pregnant couples. It's going to be Monday, this coming Monday, July 22nd, after the 5:30 Mass. So if you know anybody who is expecting a baby, please let them know. We have this blessing for pregnant couples. Again, Monday, July 22nd, after the 5:30 Mass. Also, we'll have Our Lady of San Juan Rosary Procession. And it's going to be Tuesday, July 23rd. At 6:30 p.m. And we'll meet at St. John West Side parking lot. So if anybody wants to come and pray the rosary, Tuesday, July 23rd at 6:30 p.m. Also on Tuesday, we have the Mass for elderly people at 10 a.m. So if you know anybody who wants to come and participate in that Mass as well. And this coming Saturday is going to be the last Saturday of the month. So we'll have the healing night with Monsignor Juan Nicolau. If you want to come and join us and participate in that celebration as well, to pray for healing and faith, that the Lord may heal all the sick members of our community, in our diocese, in our families. We have the raffle at the Basilica. We'll be raffling a very nice SUV and some other good prizes. So if you want to help us buying one or two tickets, we really appreciate your generosity. And after the Mass, if you want to stop by the cafeteria, we have the best brunch in town. I'm going to be there right now, having some good tacos. So if you want to come and join us at the cafeteria right next to the hotel, we have food that has been prepared with lots of love. So hopefully we'll see you there for brunch this morning. And at the end of the Mass, the icon is going to be here at the front to bless religious articles, the keys to your houses, your businesses, your vehicles, anybody who needs a special blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, vita dulcedo, es fe nostra salve.
San Juan del Valle,
pray for us.
That shines in the night.
Oh, my friends, look o'er the world, announce forgiveness and love. Heralds of the life I bring, peace and love. for all. Goodbye, friends, and be the witness of my rising from the dead. Take my presence to all people. I am always with you.